You're mighty to deliver. You're mighty to set the captive free. You are the one. You are the only one that can bring justice in the name of Jesus. And we cry out to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ, for you to have your way. Lord, that you would save those that are not saved. Save those who've been yoked by the enemy. Save those who've allowed hatred to come in and captivate their minds. Oh God, destroy the yoke of the enemy. Cast the devil out of the mind in the name of Jesus. Oh God, let your blood, the blood of Jesus Christ,
destroy the yoke of the enemy today in the name of Jesus. Oh, we need you, Lord, as never before, God. We need you the more. In the name of Jesus, have your way, God. Every ready heart, every willing mind that's listening, oh God, that's tuning in, you touch their heart today. In the name of Jesus, let your glory be revealed in their lives, oh God. Don't let them be the same. Let your word fall on the good ground of their hearts. They'll be not just hearers, but doers of your word. In the name of Jesus Christ, your will, God, your righteousness be revealed. Your holiness in the soul today, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Anoint our heads with oil. Let our cups run over today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your glory fill our souls. Ha. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Your glory be revealed. Your wonders be shown here and everywhere. The mind and the will in every ready heart, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Give us crying yes to you, Lord. Every ready heart, every willing mind, in the name of Jesus. Save in the everywhere, O God. Save and deliver, God. Draw by your spirit, O God. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let men be delivered here and everywhere. In the Nahashoko. Hayaya. Hallelujah. The will of God be done. The glory of God be revealed. In Jesus Christ today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, wonderful Savior. Wonderful Savior. We cry out to you, Lord, for your deliverance here and everywhere. For your great salvation. Save in every household. In the name of Jesus. Draw by your spirit, oh God. You're not willing any perish, but all come to repentance. You would all men be saved. Come to the knowledge of the truth. Hallelujah. Prick the heart, oh God. In the precious name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Only you can do it, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Only you can draw. Hallelujah. Only you can touch the heart. Only you can destroy the yoke. Glory to God today. The will of God be done here and everywhere. Your glory be revealed in every soul, every mind. Giving us crying yes to your Lord. Putting yes in the inner man today. Yes to your righteousness. Yes to your truth today. One that, oh, Shahaya. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The Haya. Glory to your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even through this crisis and even through all that is happening, God, let your name be glorified. Let someone cry out to you. Let them say yes to Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, we'll give you the glory. We'll give you all of the honor. We'll praise you, Lord. Bless us, oh God, every soul, every ready heart that will hear your word today. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let it fall on the good ground of our hearts. There'll be not just hearers, but doers of your word. Oh God, let that word bring forth 30, 60, even 100-fold. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Your word working in us, oh God, that we might not sin against thee. Ha-ya-ha. Glory, Yashano. Hallelujah to Jesus today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Your glory be revealed. Hey, wonderful Savior today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to God. We're in your hands, Lord. With the Hobashanahaya. Hey, wonderful Savior. Wonderful Savior today. We are the sheep of your pasture. Hallelujah. Oh, God, hallelujah. And you're able today to move mightily in every soul that'll say yes to you. And then my Savior today, hey, glory to God. Without you, we can do nothing. In you, we live, move, and have our being. And we praise you today. Now look on your little ones here in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And we'll give you praise. We'll give you glory, oh God. Hallelujah. We'll honor you, Lord. Hiya. We'll lift your great name up. Great is your name. And greatly to be praised. And we're going to tell others of your goodness. Tell others that you're a great God. And you're worthy to be praised. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank God. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. We praise the name of Jesus this morning. Truly, God is a good God. In spite of the crisis and the conditions that are happening around us, saints and friends, let's look to the hills from whence cometh our help. Our help cometh from the Lord. We are in the hands of the Lord. Hallelujah. He rains down righteousness and truth. Hallelujah. All of his works are done in truth. He told us, Jesus Christ said, let not your heart be troubled. Hallelujah. And we're troubled on every side, yet without despair. Hallelujah. Hey, there's hope in Jesus Christ. And we're believing God, that God is able to touch the hearts and minds. We know that evil and wickedness is working everywhere. But where sin abounds, grace doth much more abound. And we've got to believe God's word, saints. We cannot listen to what the system of the world is trying to tell us. The system of the world is saying to let hate and resentment rule our heart. But we've got to let the love of God be shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Ghost. We've got to say yes to the will of God, saints. Hallelujah. It's not our personal opinion and what we feel about it. We know that this was a situation that was evil and wickedly done. But you know what? God is yet in control. And we've got to hold on to his unchanging hand. When that situation happened, God was in the same place he was in when his own son gave his life for our sins. Jesus died on the cross for the sin of the world. Every sin from the beginning of mankind that has ever been done, past, present, and future, Jesus Christ took on our sin, bore our sin on the cross of Calvary and died for us. And then victoriously, he rose from the dead on the third day. And you know what? When you give your life to the Lord, he'll make a change in your life. If any man be in Christ Jesus, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are now made new, which means he gives you a new heart to serve him. And he teaches you how to love. He teaches you how to love so much so until he said, love your enemies and do good to them that despitefully use you. Oh, Jesus can say that because he came to his own and his own received him not. He went about doing good, healing all manner of sickness and disease. And yet they crucified him. Yet they called him a Beelzebub. Yet they turned away from him. But you know what? The love that God had for us in Christ Jesus was so great that Jesus did not look at how we treated him, but he looked at the love he had for us, and he suffered and died and rose again with all victory. So we have to look to Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith, saints. Look to Jesus. He is the perfect man. Psalm 37:37 says, mark the perfect man. Be wholly upright. Notice the end of that man is peace, not confusion, not hatred, not resentment, not vengeance. But the end of that man is peace. Jesus is the perfect man. And God said in his word in Romans, the 12th chapter, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. I will repay. And God knows how to pay everybody for what they've done. So you know what? Give our hearts and minds to God. Love everybody in spite of, because you know what? We're on our way to see the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you today. I thank God that we have one of our dear sisters in the Lord with us this morning who's going to come, and she's going to just sing some songs of worship and praise to magnify the Lord and to bless him. We need to sing psalms, hymns, spiritual songs, making melody in our hearts unto the Lord. We need to sing songs that bring deliverance and help to our heart. and Sister Milka Siner is going to come, and she's going to just sing as the Lord gives her this morning. Want you to join in and worship the Lord with her as she sings unto the glory and honor of our Savior Jesus Christ. Come on, Sister Milka, and she's going to let the Lord use her on this morning. If you're out there, you can say amen for her.
As the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. As the deer panteth for the water, so my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. Oh, you alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. Oh, you alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee.
Hallelujah.
Reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus, reign. Oh, reign, Jesus, reign. Reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus, reign. Oh, reign, Jesus, reign. Oh, reign, Jesus, reign. King of Zion, Judah's lion, reign, Jesus, reign.
Hallelujah. Oh, you ought to bless the Lord right where you are. You ought to give him some praise. You ought to magnify him. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. And we bless you, Lord, and we magnify you, and we honor you this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Right where you are, you ought to worship the Lord. Lift your hands to the Lord. And korabasha. Give him the glory that's due his name this morning, because his name is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You reign, God. Hallelujah. You sit on the high seat. Hallelujah. Of our hearts and our minds. Hallelujah. and you rule and reign in righteousness and truth. All of your works, God, they are done in truth, and we magnify you, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. Wonderful Savior, glory and honor belongs to you this morning. And we thank you, O God, and we praise you, and we bless you. And we ask, O God, that you would reign righteousness in our souls, in our wills. Let your kingdom come, your will be done in every ready heart, every willing mind that will say yes to you this morning. Hallelujah. Everyone that is listening, those that are sick among us, O God, and those that just need your hand touch today, that you would just lead and guide and reign and rule in righteousness and truth. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Let every yoke be destroyed. Hallelujah. Let the enemy be bound and casted out. In the name of Jesus, let these signs follow the believer. Hallelujah. Cast the devil out of the mind and out of the will today. Let your glory be revealed. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. And we praise you for it in Jesus' name, hallelujah. Thank God, amen, and amen. Again, we just thank God for the Lord Jesus allowing us to assemble again in the house of the Lord. We're here in the name of the Lord, and we're glad to be here. Saints of the Most High God, we just magnify the great God of our salvation for his wonderful gift to us. What is that gift? He's given us exceeding and precious promises. He has given us the gift of salvation. He has given us the gift of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And we thank God for Jesus Christ. God gave his only begotten Son that we might have life through his name. And we thank God for that life today. That life is in Jesus Christ. I'm glad to know Jesus in the pardon of my sins. I'm glad to know him. Hallelujah. That he is a savior, that he is a deliverer, that he is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Hallelujah. I would rather be on the side of the Lord even in troublesome times than be on the devil's side anytime in good times. God is our help and he's our strength. I do want to say that we thank God for you that are part of those of the greater St. James family. We thank God for you, every effort that you're making to continue to keep the fire burning of prayer, of study of the Word of God. We thank God for you, the prayer lines that are going forth, the saints that are praying and crying out to God. Hallelujah. We cry unto the Lord, he would hear our cry. We thank God for you, not letting anything fall to the ground, but allowing God to use you. May the Lord continue to bless you and strengthen you. We pray that the Lord will give you strength, that he will give you help. And we thank God that the Lord is raising up his people. We thank God for the healing he's given to Sister Cheryl Turner. God bless you. And to Brother Chad Siner, God bless you, Brother Siner. We thank God for the healing that God has given to you and manifest in your life. And to all of the saints of God, we want you to be encouraged. We want you to grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In the word of the Lord on this morning, we're going to be looking at in the book of Joel, and then we're going to be looking in the book of Acts. Joel, the second chapter, we're going to look at the 28th verse and go down from there. And then we're going to go to Acts 2, and we'll go from 16 to 18 in Acts, the second chapter. Again, this is Joel, the second chapter, starting at the 28th verse. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and that your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions. And also upon the servants and upon the handmaidens in those days will I pour out my spirit. And then I want you to go to the book of Acts. In the book of Acts. And then I want you to go down to go to the second chapter and then go down to the 16th verse. Amen. I know you have your phones and all of that, but I've got the old system of the book. So wait for me and I'll get there. Amen. And then second chapter, starting at 16th verse. But this is that which is spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old men shall dream dreams. And upon my servants and on my handmaiden, I will pour out my spirit. I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And the word of the Lord is blessed. We thank God for the word on today. And, you know, even with what we see going on, my dears and sirs, it is just evident that the believer needs to be filled, baptized, and filled with the Holy Ghost. We must understand that if we're going to be effective in these last days, and I certainly believe with all my heart that the Lord is soon to come. I believe according to the word of God. You know, when I was very young, and that was over 50 years ago that I was really young, they were teaching and preaching in the church that Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back. Many times it would be almost every time that someone would mount the pulpit, they would talk about the Lord's coming back. And you know what? I just believe that that's closer now than 50 years ago. I believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is coming to gather his people. And that is why it is important that we be focused and centered, that we not let these situations that's happening around us, and understand the Lord does not negate our feelings. He does not negate our emotions. The word of the Lord said in Hebrews that Jesus was tempted at all points, yet without sin, which means that Jesus felt just like we felt. We feel. Jesus went through feeling and seeing the injustice of men, especially his own brethren, the Jews, being mistreated by the Romans, just like we see situations going on with us today. Jesus is the greater than because he saw the situation, but he gave his life not only for the Jews, but for all of them, all mankind. He died for those who were in bondage and died for those who were perpetrators of the bondage. You know, it's similar, if you go to the Old Testament, what quickened in my mind was the fact that Moses saw the injustice, but Moses did what Jesus didn't do. Moses saw one of his Hebrew brethren being maliciously beaten and by an Egyptian, and his anger was so venomous, and he wanted justice, but he also took vengeance away from God, because the word of the Lord says, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And notice what happened. God had to get him out of Egypt in order to show him that God has a way to bring justice. God has a way to bring deliverance. And the only way justice can be brought is the hearts and minds of men must be changed. So we see that the effective believer must be filled with the Holy Ghost. And there is an understanding that to live a life for Christ and do the work of Christ, the Holy Ghost is vital. And that's what we have to understand. To live the life of Christ and to do the work of the Lord Jesus Christ, we must be spirit-filled. See, the church is not just an organization. The church is an organism. And notice, it's made alive through the Spirit. So in order to do the work of the Lord in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, one must be filled with the Spirit of God. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. Jesus Christ came for two specific purposes. We must always remember this, Because many times we get off track and think Jesus Christ came to give me some more finances, or Jesus Christ came to give me a house. I want you to understand, as the psalmist said, he daily loadeth us with benefits. Those are benefits to serving the Lord. But specifically, Jesus Christ came to save us from our sins and fill us with the Holy Ghost. John the Baptist said, "Behold the Lamb of God who cometh to take away the sins of the world." Then he also said, "He that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I'm not able to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire." So notice, Jesus came to save us from sin. We were born with the propensity of sinfulness and wretchedness, and we needed somebody to deliver us. Not just in terms of make us better, but deliver us and destroy the yoke that Satan had in our hearts and minds. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. So he came to fill us with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. He spoke plainly before his death and after his victorious resurrection about the Holy Ghost. And when you read in the Gospel of St. John, you will see in the latter part of the chapters of St. John, Jesus is talking to his disciples. As a matter of fact, starting from the 13th chapter on to when he's crucified, Jesus is talking adamantly about the Holy Ghost. The purpose of the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, how he's going to work in their lives, how he's going to be with them and in them, how they were to be led by the Spirit of God. And after he rose from the dead, he spoke again about the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And he said here, he said, notice that he's not just going to be with you, but he's going to be in you. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. The joy of living for Christ, hallelujah, would be by the power of the Holy Ghost. That's what I want you to understand. See, there's a joy in living for Jesus, and that comes because we are in Christ Jesus, and he's filled us with his Spirit. Notice, hallelujah, how the joy that overflows. Notice, joy unspeakable and what? Full of glory. Where does that glory come from? It comes from God the Father. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. Notice this. And notice, not only would he give us joy for living for him, but he would give us authority, listen to this now, over Satan. Hallelujah. Notice, authority or power over the enemy that would come to steal, kill, and to destroy. I wonder, do you hear me today? This essential part and importance of being filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Hey, bless the name of Jesus. Now, Joel the prophet spoke here in Joel, the second chapter, 28 through 29. He's dealing with the pouring out, that God would pour out his Spirit upon all flesh. Notice, God would indwell, envelop the believer. Hallelujah. Notice, upon all those who believe God, who trusted the true and living God, the one true God, the God of the scriptures, the God of the Bible, they would be endowed with the power of the Holy Ghost. God unveiled the direction by which he would operate in the life of the children of Israel. Notice, he wanted, God desired, hallelujah, Israel to have his Spirit, have his power. Notice this, I want you to understand this. Israel had the law, but they couldn't come up to the law because they didn't have the power within them. And see, God was revealing to them that, see, you can't do right just because you want to do right. You've got to have the power of God in you to do right. Are you listening to me? You got to have the do right in you. And see, through the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, because Jesus has destroyed the yoke of the devil and filled us with his Spirit, he gives us the do right to obey him. We have a desire. See, the Holy Ghost in us, hey, bless the name of Jesus, always draws us closer to Jesus. See, anytime you have a spirit that's pushing you away from Jesus, that is not the Spirit of God. The Holy Ghost is continuously, not only did he draw you into salvation, God's saving grace, but he's drawing you constantly into sanctification. Oh, to be like Jesus. Hallelujah. Saints of God, that's what we need to be striving for. As we're looking around and seeing what's happening around us, what is our spirit about this? What spirit are we allowing to take our mind and our heart? Yes, we're angry. Yes, everybody has an emotion of anger. That's why the word of the Lord says, be angry and sin not. But are we going to let the enemy control our emotions and feelings about this? Or are we going to settle our hearts and hear what the Lord has to say? Are you listening today? Hallelujah. So notice this. Notice this. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to his name. His power would be in every person that submitted to him. It was a great mystery that was revealed on the day of Pentecost. So on the day of Pentecost, God unfolds that great mystery of how, notice, that word, hallelujah, would be flesh and spirit. Notice this. Oh, bless his name. Notice, he told the prophet, he said, listen, I'm going to take my word and I'm not going to write it on tables of stone, but I'm going to write it in your heart. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. So now when Jesus came and saved us and delivered us and destroyed the yoke of the enemy and placed within us a new heart and a new mind, that word that lives, that word that ever liveth, hallelujah, is in us. And we have a desire to please God. Are you listening today? Tell the Lord thank you if you would. Notice this. Notice this. Hallelujah. It was a great mystery that was revealed on the day of Pentecost or the day of abundance. Notice the day of abundance. Paul stands and references Joel as he explains the unusual happening. Notice the Holy Ghost came in, a rushing mighty wind filled all the house where they were sitting, and cloven tongues fell like as a fire, hallelujah, set upon each of them. And the Bible says they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. It wasn't just a select few. Bless the name of Jesus. Everybody up there, the apostles that were there, everybody that was in there was filled with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. God wants every believer enveloped, empowered in the Spirit. Are you listening to me today? Why do we live beneath our privilege when we're trying to struggle and do what's right when we need to let the do right work in us? Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. Tell the Lord thank you today. Praise the name of Jesus. Notice Jesus Christ was the bridge that connected the believer to the power and presence of God. Notice because he died, he made it possible for us to be filled with the Spirit. There's no way in the world that you can have the Spirit of God in you outside of Jesus Christ. The Holy Ghost, he honors Jesus. Hallelujah. There are God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost does the work, does the operation of what God the Father and God the Son desires. So in order for us to have the Spirit of God, we've got to have Jesus Christ. He has to be the Lord of our life. He has to sit on the high seat of our lives. Hallelujah. He can't just be an individual just moved in and just living there. He has to be in control of our life. And through him being in control in our life and the blood of Jesus cleansing us from all sin, he fills us with the presence of God. Tell oh, Shatta. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I felt that one in my soul. Haya, bless his holy name. He fills us with all the fullness of God. And we can say yes to the will of God today. Tell the Lord thank you if you would. Hallelujah. Notice this. The believer to the, notice this. Jesus Christ is bridges that connection to the believer to the power and presence of God. His death, burial, and glorious resurrection opened up the door to access to the access of God's glorious Spirit. Now notice, any individual can say, Lord, fill me with your Spirit. I want you to fill me, Lord. You know what? And that even goes for you, my dears and sirs. You've been saved. You said, well, I was baptized with the Spirit way back in 19 this or 19 that. That's wonderful. Thank God for that. But you know what? You need to ask God to fill you again. Every time you get opportunity, you need to say, Lord, fill me with your spirit. Even now in these rough times that we're going through, we need the Holy Ghost working in us. Because if we don't have the Holy Ghost, the enemy of fear will come. The enemy of hate and resentment will come to our heart and take control of our heart. That's why we've got to say, Lord, fill me with the Holy Ghost. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. Notice this. The Holy Ghost would not only be with the believer. Notice this. But the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, would be in the believer. That's John 14:17. Jesus said, he's not just going to be with you, but he's going to be in you. It makes the difference. Hallelujah. See, a person can feel the presence of the Lord, but that doesn't necessarily mean they've been baptized in the Spirit. Are you listening to me? And you know what? It goes back to King Saul when we go to 1 Samuel. You know what, King Saul? God had placed his anointing on King Saul, hallelujah, to lead his people. But Saul became rebellious. He became disobedient, and God withdrew his spirit. On one occasion, he came around the prophets, and all of a sudden, the anointing of the Lord got on him, and he began to prophesy and did not cease. And they made the statement, they said, is Saul among the prophets? But you know what? After all of that, he got up and still was trying to kill David. Are you listening to me? See, it's not only just feeling good, and in the Pentecostal Holiness Church, we believe in dancing in the Spirit. We believe in speaking in other tongues. We believe in raising our hands. We believe in praising God through expression in terms of lifting our hand and all of that. And all of that's wonderful. But after all of that is over, I got to obey God. When all of that's ended and the music is gone and the songs have ended and service has ended and I go on my way, I've got to yet have God's presence and power in my life to keep me. That's hallelujah. That's why he said, now unto him that is able to keep you from falling. How is he going to keep us from falling? Through the power of the Holy Ghost that's working in our lives. Are you listening today? Tell the Lord thank you. Understand this clearly. I want you to get understanding on this. When we receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, hallelujah, through repentance, hallelujah, faith in him and repentance, then notice that we are born again. So I want you to understand that. When you go to the Gospel of St. John, the 3rd chapter, Jesus expresses in detail how a person is born again as he speaks to Nicodemus. All right. The new birth is by the water, which is the word, and by the spirit, John 3:5. The word of God and the spirit of God through faith in Jesus Christ gives us life. So now as we're born again, we have new life within us. We are alive in Christ. We are in fellowship with God. Hallelujah. Through Jesus Christ. Notice this. However, Jesus did not end there, because as you continue to read the Gospel of St. John, Jesus is emphasizing, continues to emphasize that the believer needs to be baptized and filled with the Spirit. Now notice, I want you to read and ask God to give us a spiritual understanding. Jesus in the Gospel of St. John, the 3rd chapter, is talking about new life, being born into the family of God. But now notice, to operate and function. And notice, I want you to also understand, because he knew that the disciples weren't going to die the minute that they got saved. They weren't going to die. They were going to keep on living. So he told them, go to Jerusalem and tarry till you receive power from the Holy Ghost. Now notice, he didn't tell the thief on the cross that, because the thief on the cross was dying. I want you to understand, he didn't tell the thief on the cross, now you need to tarry for the Holy Ghost. No, he said, today thou shalt be with me in paradise, which meant the very minute that he believed on the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior, he was accepted into the kingdom. But Jesus knew that his disciples were going to continue on his work. So he said, listen now, you're saved because you believe on me, but you need to be baptized and filled with the Spirit of God. And so many times we need to understand that it's not church work. We're not doing this so we can get something from God. We're not just doing this because we're talented or we have an ability. We have to do this, hey, glory to God, in the power of the Holy Ghost. In order to be effective, not just to go through the motions, but we need the Holy Ghost to lead us and guide us so that somebody can be touched, their hearts can change, and not only change, but they can grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Are you listening today? This is an essential part of the believer being filled with the Holy Ghost. Not the Casper, the friendly ghost, not some ghost that somebody conjured up, but being filled with the Holy Ghost. Because when you're filled with the Holy Ghost, you're led by the Spirit of God. You have the fruit of the Spirit in your life. Are you listening to me? You're not just operating in a gift. Hallelujah. You have to have the fruit and the gift operating together. Are you listening to me today? Oh, bless his name. I'm going to go as the Lord lead me today. Hallelujah. Notice, we got life in Jesus Christ. We are alive in Christ. We are in fellowship with him. Notice, however, Jesus continued to emphasize that the believer needed to be baptized and filled with the Spirit. Hallelujah. Simply way to put it is, we must be submerged in and controlled by the Spirit of God. There it is. We must be submerged in and controlled by the Spirit of God. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. The fullness of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, is God in our heart. Oh, bless his name. I can shout right there. I feel the presence of the Lord. The Holy Ghost is God in our heart, God in our mind, God in our soul, hallelujah, working in us, the willing to do of his good pleasure, hallelujah, as we honor the Son and yield ourselves, and Christ has the high seat in our life, then God, through the Holy Ghost, leads our spirit, leads our soul, leads our heart and mind. Are you listening to me? That's why as you go along and situations happen, the Holy Ghost will bring a scripture to your mind. Even as I was up early and was earlier today and watching all of the riots and everything, and God began to bring to my mind his word, his word about how Moses did, didn't have control of his emotions and got so angry that he committed murder, how Cain was so angry that he committed murder. All of these individuals, why? Because they did not yield themselves to the Holy Ghost. Every believer should be saying, listen now, we need to calm ourselves, let God be God, and he's going to give justice. Are you listening to me? God is a God of justice. And you know what? My late grandfather preached a message one day, you may get by, but you're not getting away. Anyone that does ungodliness and mistreats folks, you may get by, but you're not going to get away. Vengeance belongs to God. Are you listening to me? Yes, we want justice. Hallelujah. True. Any right-minded individual wants justice, but vengeance belongs to God, and he's able. I want to let you know, hallelujah, people of color have been mistreated down through the centuries of in this country. Hallelujah. But God has yet been with us. We haven't been destroyed. We haven't been annihilated. We're still here. Are you listening to me? You know why? Because years ago, our fourth parents cried out to God and said, God, make a better way for my children. God, be with my children. We need to be doing as they did in the 60s. We need to be getting on our knees on the street corners and crying out to God to work this out. Crying out and say, Lord, have your way. Are you listening to me today? Not getting all upset and angry, allowing the devil to rule our mind and bring hate against some people who haven't done anything against us. I'm here to tell you, there's devils in every ethnic group. Are you listening to me? There's devils and demons in every ethnic group. And what needs to be done is the heart needs to be changed. Are you listening to me? And you know what? While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. All of us had an evil and wicked heart, and Jesus yet died for us. Are you listening to me today? Can you tell the Lord thank you? Tell you, glory to his name today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We need to be spirit controlled. Hallelujah. The fullness of the Holy Ghost is God in our heart, God in our mind, God in our soul. Hallelujah. It is filled to overflowing. Are you listening to me? We need to have an overflowing presence of God. Every now and then, you need, glory to God, the Holy Ghost just needs to just overflow in you. Are you listening to you? You walk around and you're in the Lord and you're dry and dismal and bleak. You know what you need to ask the Lord? To fill you to overflowing. Shake you again. Hallelujah. Fill your spirit. Hallelujah. If you keep asking God to fill you, he will do it. Hallelujah. Fill you with the presence and power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. To set your heart on fire. Sometimes you're going along in church and you become bored and dull and going through ritual. You need to ask God to shake you again, fill you again. You need to have a consecration before God and say, God, fill me like you did when you first filled me with your spirit. Touch me again. Anoint my head with oil. Let my cup run over. Hiya. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Every now and then, you need to experience the overflow of the presence and power of God. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. Tell the Lord thank you. Tell the Lord thank you today. Hallelujah. Full to overflowing. Hallelujah. And not only in joy and exuberance. Are you listening to me? But also in constant obedience and submission to his directive. So now notice now, he will fill us to overflowing and we will feel his presence and we will go forth and praise him and magnify him in other tongues as the Spirit of God give utterance, not something that somebody taught you, and you don't just start speaking because somebody tells you to speak. You speak as the Spirit give utterance. And he will, you know what? If the Holy Ghost, he is intelligent. And he knows what to do. And he knows how to speak. Hallelujah. He will give you a heavenly language where you will magnify and praise the Lord. And after all that settled down, you'll know how to live holy too. Because the Holy Ghost is not just going to give me to feel good and fall out and all of that and then get up and not live for the Lord. Are you listening to me? I want you to understand that, because we live in a day where people have let the devil warp their mind to feel like that, you know what, they can dance in the spirit or dance in whatever spirit they have and shout and do all of that exercise, and then after everything over, they can carry on in an ungodly lifestyle. You can't have God and the devil at the same time. You can't be filled with God and filled with the devil at the same time. Are you listening to me? You can't be full of God on Sunday or whenever service comes and you're around the people of God and then be full of the devil all the other time. If you're filled with the God then, you're going to be filled with God as you go day by day. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. There has to be a constant obedience and submission to God's direction. So you know what God, Jesus said in the Gospel of St. John, the 16th chapter, he said that the Holy Ghost will lead you and guide you into all truth. So the Holy Ghost, the Spirit of God, leads us into truth. I wonder, do you hear me today? Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost doesn't lead us or veer us away from God's word. He always gives us and lifts God's word up in our heart and then gives us a greater understanding of God's word. See, you can't understand the word of God unless you have the Holy Ghost. Now, you can try and do it and sit down and read and do all of that, all you want to do. But I'm here to tell you, you need the Holy Ghost to give you understanding. Are you listening to me today? You need the Holy Ghost to give you understanding, my dears. Hallelujah. You know, some people feel like, well, they can just go on and just, you know, read it and everything and feel all right. And, you know, but you know what? You really don't get the presence and power of it, hallelujah, until you ask the Holy Ghost to give you understanding. Are you listening today? I'm just about finished. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to also understand this, because I'm just about finished here. Hallelujah. The baptism of the Holy Ghost is, hallelujah, what Christ desires for every believer. Every believer is to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Not some, not a few, not, you know, just the elders or missionaries or the leaders of the church. He wants from the pulpit to the door. He wants every person, no matter what their age is. He wants every individual, no matter what their ethnicity is. He wants everybody to be filled with the Holy Ghost. So don't say, well, that operates in this person. Now, he may give you a specific gift. He may not give you a gift like somebody else, but he wants you filled with the Spirit. Am I making any sense today? Hallelujah. Tell the Lord thank you today. He wants every believer filled with the Spirit. Now notice, Jesus breathed on the disciples and said in John 20:22, he said, "Receive ye the Holy Ghost." Listen to this now. He had, hallelujah, continually preached to them of the Spirit. And now he was getting their hearts and their minds centered on receiving the Spirit. So after he gloriously is resurrected from the dead and then comes to his disciples, he says, listen now, receive ye the Holy Ghost. What he wants their minds and hearts conditioned to go to Jerusalem and tarry and wait till they be endowed with power from on high. Are you listening today? He knew they along with us would need the Holy Ghost, hey, glory to God, to conquer the world, the flesh, and the devil. There's our enemy right there. The system of this world is our enemy. The flesh, our flesh is our enemy, and the devil. Are you listening to me? You know what? Sometimes, I never shall forget it. Our late pastor here at Greater St. James, he got up and said, next Sunday, I'm going to show you who the devil is. And oh my goodness, everybody said, oh, Pastor gonna show us who the devil is. And folk came to the service that next Sunday and he showed us who the devil was. He showed us we the devil. Oh, y'all ain't with me today. He said, listen now, if you're letting the devil lead you and guide you, then you're children of the devil. And I'm here to tell you, you know what? You're either in God or you're not. You're either in fellowship with the Lord or you're not. You've either repented of your sins and confessed faith in Jesus Christ, or you're not. You can be a spectator and not a participator. Are you listening to me today? Hey, bless the name of Jesus. No, notice what? He continually preached to them of the Spirit, and now he was getting their hearts and their minds conditioned to receive. To receive what? The Holy Ghost, the Spirit of God. He knew that they along with us would need the Holy Ghost to conquer the world, the flesh, and the devil. He knew that they, like us, would be, hallelujah, limited in our effectiveness, hallelujah, for Christ without the baptism in the Holy Ghost. We need to understand that. If we don't seek for the more of God, it limits us in how God can use us effectively for his kingdom. Jesus, well, you know what? Jesus had the power. As a matter of fact, it said after he left out of the wilderness, he went in the power of the Spirit. So Jesus, hallelujah, was led by the Spirit of God. He was a man just like us, and he had the Holy Ghost leading him and guiding him. How much more is he saying to us that we need the Holy Ghost to be effective in what God has called us to do? Not just doing it for the motions, not just doing it to say I belong to church or I go to that church. No, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost so God can lead me and guide me so I can live a life for Christ and I can do a work for the Lord. How you listening today? Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. He told them to go to Jerusalem and wait for the promise of the Father. Hallelujah. Which is the Holy Ghost. Acts 1:4-5. They were saved. Listen now. They were saved. Notice they were born again. In the Gospel of St. John, the 3rd chapter, Jesus says you must be born again of the water and the Spirit. The disciples were saved because they believed on the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. However, hallelujah, they needed to be filled with the fullness of Christ. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God, in order to do a work for the Lord. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. They needed to be filled with all the fullness of Christ. Hallelujah. The fullness of Christ to work for Christ. Hallelujah. And to be conformed to the image of his dear son. To be like Christ. That's why we need the Holy Ghost, my dears and sirs. To be like Jesus. See, without the presence and power of the Holy Ghost, we'll think we're all right. We'll think we got it okay. But you know what the Holy Ghost does? He convicts the world of sin, of righteousness, and judgment. The Holy Ghost, he doesn't let anything that God doesn't want, he doesn't let it rest in us. If there's something that God is not pleased with, the Holy Ghost will trouble you and show you God is not pleased with that action. God is not pleased with that behavior. God is not pleased with what you're doing. And he's doing that to draw you back into fellowship with God through Jesus Christ. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. When the Holy Ghost troubles you about something, thank God he's troubling you. You don't want him to leave you alone. Oh, bless his name. That's why David said, don't let your spirit, don't take your spirit away from me. Hallelujah. And he knew that it was vital for the anointing of God to be upon him. How much more is it vital for the Holy Ghost to dwell in us? We can't live for God outside the power of God. We need God's spirit to obey God. We need God's spirit to say yes to God. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost shows us that this world is fleeting and transitory. It shows us, my dears and sirs, that you know what? Jesus is soon to come. I don't know about you, but the Holy Ghost keeps stirring in my spirit that the Lord is soon to come. No, the Holy Ghost haven't told me what day that Jesus is coming, because I know that that's not the Spirit of God. But the Holy Ghost keeps my mind, hey, glory to God, to keep my lamp trimmed and burning. Keep my mind centered on the Lord. Keep my mind out of the foolishness of this world, out of the deceitfulness and trickery that's in this world. Keep my heart pure with all diligence. Hiya. Tell the Lord, thank you today. Holy Ghost convicts our heart, convicts us of righteousness, sin. Hallelujah. Let us know if we're wrong, the Holy Ghost is there to get us right. Thank God he's there to get us right. Because if God has left us alone, that means we're not his children. Are you listening to me? Thank God that God loves us enough to get us right. Thank you, God. I want you to get me right. Show me myself. Show me where I'm wrong. Show me where I need to come up, because I want to be more like you. And the Holy Ghost, as we yield ourselves to the Holy Ghost, and glory to God through Jesus Christ, then we submit ourselves and say, yes, God, you're right and I'm wrong. Yeah, glory to God. Can you tell the Lord thank you today? Wonderful Savior. Yeah, we're being conformed, my dears and sirs, into the image of Jesus Christ. I keep saying this, and if I say it every Sunday or every week, I'm going to keep saying it. God is not trying to make an improved us. God doesn't want a better us. God doesn't want a new and improved us. He wants us in the image of his dear son. And it takes a whole lot to be like Jesus. It's not a six-week course in biblical studies to be like Jesus. You just can't go and say, well, I joined the church and that. No, you got to walk with God. You got to submit to him. You got to go through down times with him. You got to go through trouble with him. Hallelujah. Hey, bless the name of Jesus. Where he works in you, the willing to do of his good pleasure. Tell the Lord, thank you today. Hallelujah. Where he guides you into the righteousness, all of his righteousness, and you see him more clearly. Hey, glory to God. Wonderful Savior today. Hallelujah to God. Wonderful Savior. Hey, I'm just about finished here. The Holy Ghost points us to Jesus. Thank you. See, that's what I want you to understand. The Holy Ghost, he points us to Jesus. He gets us focused on Jesus. The Holy Ghost, even in situations that we see, all of the riot and all of that, even through that, If you are living for the Lord and filled with the presence of God, the Holy Ghost is pointing you to Jesus. You know, you know what? God lets us know. God is not in heaven trying to figure out what to do. He knows the end from the beginning. Are you listening to me? And so if we follow on to know him through Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Ghost points out to us, listen, this is what the Lord is trying to say in this situation. You need to be telling folks that are around you, listen, you need to let God be the Lord of your life. You need to come to Jesus. Yes, this is troubling. Yes, our hearts are broken because of it. But you know what? Hallelujah. You need to be right with God. Are you listening today? Hey, glory to God. The Holy Ghost points us to Jesus. The Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit confirms what Jesus has said. Are you listening to me? The Holy Ghost gives confirmation to what Jesus said, because Jesus said the Holy Ghost is going to speak what I speak. There, you know what? The only new revelation that comes is the revelation that comes in our heart as we read the word, as God exposes more of his word to us. Because we can't take it all in one setting. His word is so power-packed and filled with who he is, because he said he honors his word above his name. We can't take it. I don't care how much you read that scripture. You may read one scripture every day, but God will give you a new insight to that scripture. Hallelujah. That's the only revelation that comes. There's no other greater revelation that's coming outside of the word of God. Are you listening to me today? Don't be caught up with the trickery of the enemy that's going on. You know, everybody's on Facebook. Everybody's talking about the Lord. But does it line up with Scripture? Because if it lines up with Scripture, the Holy Ghost will give confirmation and let you know that's from God. Why? Because it lines up with the Word of God. What I'm preaching to you right now, as I preach the Word of God, the Holy Ghost will show you if I'm telling the truth. Holy Ghost will let you know, yeah, he's telling the truth. If I'm not, he'll say, no, that ain't right. You know why? Because if it's in the word of God, it lines up with who God is. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. I don't care who comes and all of these wonders and things. And don't you know that the devil can do stuff too? The devil can operate and do stuff. Somebody say, well, what are you talking about, Pastor Marco? You know what? When Moses came before Pharaoh and he threw down his rod and it turned into a serpent, do you know that Pharaoh brought his magicians and they threw down their rods and they turned into serpents too? But you know what? God showed his greatness, because Moses' rod that turned into a serpent ate up all of the magician's rod, and then Moses picked it up and it turned back to a rod. That shows you the enemy has some power, but God has all power. But notice, Moses stood on what God had told him to tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Moses didn't get mesmerized by what the magicians did and say, wow, yeah, that must be of God too. No, he didn't. He knew who had called him. And the Holy Ghost lets you know if you're in God. Are you listening to me today? Hey, glory to God. Hey, wonderful Savior. The Holy Ghost confirms what Jesus said. The Holy Ghost gives power, oh, bless his name, to obey what Jesus said. That's it. See, the Holy Ghost gives us power in the inner man to say yes to God, to be obedient. What does it mean to have all that anointing and all of that, you know, gifts? Because gifts and callings come without repentance. We need to understand that. Just because a person is gifted doesn't mean that they're yielded to the Spirit of God. We have to understand, we got to obey God. You know what? Even if God doesn't give you one or two gifts, you know what? Let the fruit of the Spirit reign in you. Are you listening to me today? Hey, glory to God. Tell the Lord, thank you. Wonderful Savior today. Hallelujah. He, the Spirit of truth, leads and guides us into all truth. Are you listening to me? It is vitally important, hallelujah, to understand that the Holy Ghost makes spiritual gifts available. Listen to me now. Through Jesus Christ. Listen, but those spiritual gifts operate because there's a consistent growth of the fruit of the Spirit. See, the gifts and the fruit are connected. Because the fruit is operating and the gifts will flow from the fruit of the Spirit. Are you listening to me? To be effective. I'm not talking about to go through the motions or to try to project yourself. See, because first of all, if you're led by the Spirit of God, you're not trying to project yourself. You yield yourself to God because the Holy Ghost doesn't try and take on a name for himself. And as believers, if we're led by the Spirit of God, we shouldn't be trying to take a name for ourselves. I'm preaching today. Hallelujah. Those gifts operate because there's a constant growth of the fruit of the Spirit. Hallelujah. You cannot function, hallelujah, in one area and not in the other. So the fruit is vital. You know, everybody wants to be anointed. Everybody wants to have power. But how is the fruit of the Spirit operating in you? See, don't tell me about speaking in other tongues and you can't speak to me right. Don't tell me about laying on the hands and you have hate and resentment in your heart towards your brother and sister. Are you listening to me? After everything is over, you've got some animosity and you've got something negative to say about your brother and sister, and you just got finished all laying on their hands and running down the aisle and all of that kind of thing. Nothing wrong with praising God. Nothing's wrong with that. But it all works together, because after all that's done, we have to have love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, meekness, temperance. All of these things have to work in us, hey, glory to God, so that the gift of the Spirit can operate effectively. See, we've gotten off course. We've been focusing on the gifts. Oh, I've got this gift. Well, how's your fruit operating? Do you love everybody? Are you patient with folks? Do you gossip and talk about your brother and sister in Christ? Do you have resentment against somebody in the body? Are you mistreating folks or manipulating their lives? You can't operate in all of that. And you know what? I say it like this. You can do it, but it's not effective before God. You know what? The Lord said, Jesus said this. He said, in that day, many going to come to me and say, Lord, I did this in your name. Woo! Hey, glory to God. Every time I read that part of the scripture with Jesus, I examine my heart. Because he said, they're going to say, I did this. I did great works in your name. I did this. I built this. I did it. And you know what Jesus is going to say? Oh, God, help us today. Depart from me, ye worker of iniquity. I don't even know you. Saints and deers and sons, this is serious business. Hallelujah. It's not just functioning in the gift of the Spirit. It's also letting the fruit of the Spirit grow and develop in us that we conform to the image of Jesus Christ. Are you listening to me today? Tell the Lord, thank you wherever you are. The fruit of the Spirit, hallelujah, is just as important as the gifts of the Spirit. I believe because the word of God says and lets us know in the Acts of the Apostles, when they received the baptism in the Spirit, they spake in other tongues and Spirit God gave them utterance. They spake in other tongues. Hallelujah. They spake in tongues as the Spirit of God gave utterance. I believe that when the Holy Spirit baptized in the Spirit, God will give you, hallelujah, his spiritual language, not a spiritual language, but his spiritual language. But that spiritual language doesn't mean anything if you cannot speak to your brother and sister in love. Have compassion and mercy. Have grace for one another. Are you listening to me? As a matter of fact, in 1 Corinthians 13 chapter, he says, you know what it is? It's tinkling brass. Tinkling cymbals. It's just noise. It doesn't mean anything. See, whatever I do for Christ, I want it to mean something. Hallelujah. I want him to get the glory out of it. I want him to get the honor out of it. Are you listening to me? Whatever we do, we want God to receive the glory. Not us, oh God, but you. Are you listening today? Tell the Lord, thank you today. Jesus said, by their fruit ye shall know them. Hallelujah. So therefore, if the fruit of the Spirit operates in the believer, the gifts of the Spirit will flow. I believe that. As the fruit of the Spirit is operating in us, as we're growing in grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the gifts of the Spirit, hallelujah, they will flow in our lives. The spiritual life that is in us is sealed by the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. We walk in the newness of life and grow in grace, the grace of God. Notice this, flesh and carnality cannot operate when the Spirit is in control. See, if you're operating in flesh, the Holy Ghost is not in control. If you're operating in you, if you're operating because you want to be seen or you want to do that, or you want everybody to say how wonderful you are. As a matter of fact, Jesus said, you got your reward already. See, whatever we're doing that Christ be glorified. Not I. You know what? We need to take the mindset of John the Baptist. He must increase, I must decrease. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. He must increase. I must decrease. I don't want him to see me, God. I want him to see you using me for your glory. Are you listening to me today? Tell the Lord thank you wherever you are. Tell him thank you wherever you are. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The flesh and carnality can't operate when the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost, is in control. The life of Christ is, hallelujah, daily lived through the Holy Ghost. So this is a daily thing. The Holy Ghost is to operate in us from the time we wake up in the morning to the time we close our eyes to go to sleep. The Holy Ghost should be working in us. There's no time that we take a vacation from the Holy Spirit. There's no time that we say, oh, you know, well, I don't need you today. We need him every day. The enemy comes against our mind. He comes against our heart. He comes against our family. Hallelujah. Hey, glory to God. You say you've raised them in the church and they know all about God and you've been an example before them and they still act like they don't even know God. That's why you need the power of God working in you. They say, Lord, help me. Help them, God, to pray for them. We need the Spirit of God as we pray. Saints of God, we don't know how to pray, but the Holy Ghost picks up for us. Thank you, God. Sometimes you can't pray. You've been so hurt or situations happen and you don't even know what to say, but you say, oh, God, and God gets a whole paragraph out of that, oh, God. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Sometimes all you can do is be on your knees saying, oh, God, have mercy. Oh, God, have mercy. Hallelujah. And the Holy Ghost interprets that and takes it to the Father. Thank you, God. Can you tell the Lord thank you today? Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. There is a continued submission to the Word of God and to the will of God. Hallelujah. You know what it is? Paul said, no more I, but the Christ that lives in me. Hallelujah. See, the Holy Ghost, he helps that to be effective in us. No more I, but Jesus Christ in us. Hallelujah. The power given by God is in the Holy Ghost. Jesus said, ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Hallelujah. Power deals with authority. Power deals with change. Are you listening to me? It is the authority to change. Glory to God. God gives us the authority through the Holy Ghost to change things in our lives and also things around us. Power to change. Are you listening to me? Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost empowers us to change conditions within and without. See, a lot of times when God changes us, he'll change our circumstance. Are you listening to me? Sometimes situations are going on because God is working in you, his willing to do. And as you yield yourself to the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, and say yes to God, then God moves in your behalf. Thank you, Jesus. That's how faith operates, saints. Are you listening? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, glory to God. You know what? The Holy Ghost backs up the word of God. Hallelujah. He energizes our faith in God. Hallelujah. He energizes our faith. So you need power and you need the Holy Ghost to energize your faith. To energize your faith, give you a jump start in your faith. Are you listening to me today? Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. He takes the authority over the attacks and the assault of the wicked one. The devil comes to attack us. You know what the first place he's attacking us? In our mind. That's why we need the Holy Ghost. We need the Holy Ghost to take control of our thinking. Because the devil will come and attack us. We'll get sick, and then we'll think, oh my goodness, this is happening. Oh, you know, and then you know what? Many times we've grown, you know, I say this from experience. You've seen in your early age somebody die. And what the enemy will do is work death in your mind. And so you think you're going to die too. So every time situation happens, you get sick or whatever, the enemy is working to see you're going to die. So you need the power of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, to bind the enemy and cast him out of your mind and say, I shall live and not die to declare the works of the Lord. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. My mind, my thinking belongs to God. I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. I'm healed by his stripes today. I'm delivered by the word of God. Can you tell the Lord thank you? And the more you saturate your mind with the word of God, the more you have weaponry against the enemy. The sword of the spirit is the word of God. Are you listening to me today? Hallelujah. Tell the Lord thank you today. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah. So the enemy is going to attack. Don't think he's not. If he went against Jesus, he's going to go against us. If he tried to make Jesus depart from his mission, he's trying to make us depart from ours. He came to and accused Jesus and tried to make him feel as though he wasn't who he said he is. But Jesus held on to the word of God in the power of the Spirit. And the devil had to get out of the way. Are you listening to me today? Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost reproves Satan and lets him know that his kingdom is defeated. Hallelujah. Hey, the Holy Ghost also lets us know that we are victorious. That's his name. See, that's what I wanted to let you know. You are victorious. Hallelujah. Well, I'm sick, but you're still victorious. Well, I've got trouble in my home, but you're still victorious. Well, I don't have the finances I need, but I'm victorious. Hey, glory to God. Oh, you know, my children are acting up. I'm victorious. You are a victor. You're not a victim. You are a victor in Jesus Christ. You are filled with the Holy Ghost. You are living for the Lord. You've got the victory. Understand, God allows situations to try our faith, to test our faith. But you know what Jesus said? I pray that your faith faileth not. God wouldn't allow anything to happen to you to destroy you. Whatever happens in your life, he filled you with enough power in the Holy Ghost to conquer it. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. He reaffirms that victory is ours in our everyday life. That I want to see, the Holy Ghost doesn't just operate in our church life. He operates in our everyday life. Every day that we wake up, he's operating in us and lets us know the victory is ours. And even this, saints, even in death, hallelujah, we have the victory. If this spirit which raised up Christ from the dead, if that spirit dwell in you, he shall also quicken your mortal body. So we are winners. We have the victory either way. While I'm living, I have the victory in the power of the Holy Ghost. And when I leave here, hey, glory to God. God's going to raise me up by the power of the Holy Ghost. Are you listening today? Hallelujah. Jesus took the sting out of death. And you know what? And the Holy Ghost, he made it possible for the Holy Ghost to quicken our mortal body. Hallelujah. As we yield ourselves to the Spirit, hallelujah, hey, we know beyond a shadow of a doubt, hallelujah, hey, bless his name, hallelujah. And what do we know? Hallelujah, we have all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of Jesus Christ. That's 2 Peter, the first chapter, the third verse. And notice, we see clearly. See, the Holy Ghost helps us to see clearly. He opens up our eyes to see clearly that all things work together for good to them that love the Lord, to them that are called according to his purpose. That's Romans 8:28. Saints, I want you to hold on. Hallelujah. I want you to know, hallelujah, that the Spirit of God, he is working in you, the righteousness of God through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And my dears and my sirs, my friends, if you haven't received the baptism in the Spirit, the fullness of the Holy Ghost. You're saved and you love the Lord, but you want to experience that joy, that full to overflowing presence and power of God. Just ask the Lord to fill you. Say, Lord, fill me with the Spirit of God. Fill me with your presence, with your power. On this week, even if you have to fast and pray and say, God, do it again. Ask him to have his way in your life. We need the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. In our lives, working in us as we see the day approaching. And the day, saints, is approaching. So let's hold on. Hey, glory to God, and believe God's word. Trust that he's able to bring it to pass in our lives. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for your word. I thank you for your word today. Hallelujah. I thank you for what you've imparted into my spirit. Aha. Glory to your name. And speak to all of us. Hallelujah. Of your anointing, pouring out your spirit upon all flesh. Hallelujah. That we can be used for your glory and unto your honor. Have your way in every ready heart. Hallelujah. Every willing mind that will say yes to you. Lord, I pray that your word will not fall, hallelujah, by the wayside, but it will fall in the good ground of every heart that will hear your word today. Bind the enemy in the name of Jesus that comes to hinder that word, and let that word grow richly in us in all knowledge and wisdom of you. In the precious name of Jesus. And Father, we will give you praise and give you glory. In the blessed name of Jesus, we pray. Thank God. Amen. Sing this song with me, if you would. Lord, let it be in me. Lord, let it be in me. Whatever it takes for me to live eternally. Lord, let it be in me. Lord, let it be in me. Lord, let it be in me. Whatever it takes for me to live eternally. Lord, let it be in me. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let it be in me, God. Let it be in our hearts today. I want to thank God for you, you and you, even you, who have tuned in to be a part of the worship that we have here at Greater St. James. We pray that the Lord has blessed you through the living word, that the word, hallelujah, will fall on the good ground of your heart, that you'll say yes to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And let him live victoriously in your life. We're again praying for all of the Lord's people, that the Lord will strengthen you, that he will comfort your heart, that he will take you through it. He's able to do exceeding and abundant above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us by Christ Jesus. I do want to encourage you, my dears and my sirs, let's be a supportive factor in the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you're a member of this great church, let's not forget to support and give. Amen. Let's let the Lord touch our heart. Although we're not here, things continue to go on. Things are being taken care of here at the church. Also, we're preparing to receive the Lord's people. We will let you know what date that will be, because we want to make certain everything is in place. There are directives that we're going to ask everyone to follow and be obedient to. Some things, and we need to understand that the things are not going to be the same as they were prior to this COVID-19 situation. And just as the various stores and various businesses have things in place, the church will have things set in place that we're going to ask every person to adhere to. So because we're doing that, we don't just want to jump up and jump in. We want to make sure everything's set in line and you know exactly what we're doing. So please continue to pray, seek the Lord, continue to be encouraged in the Lord, and let's give. We ask that everyone to give and be a blessing. If you can let the Lord touch your heart by giving $50, you can give by PayPal, you can give by Givelify, you can also give by mailing your check or money order to the Greater St. James Temple, Post Office Box 1083. That's Greater St. James Temple, Post Office Box 1083, and that is in North Chicago, Illinois, 60064. Let the Lord touch your heart. If you can sow a seed and be a blessing to the work of the Lord by giving $50. Now, whatever you give, the Lord is going to bless you because you have a ready heart and a willing mind. All we're doing, the word of the Lord said, you have not because you ask not. And all we do is ask. And you let the Lord touch your heart, because whatever you give, God is going to honor that. So we would that you would support the work of the Lord by giving by PayPal. We're on PayPal. We are also with Givelify, and you can mail your check or money order to the Greater St. James Temple, Post Office Box 1083. And that's the great city of North Chicago, Illinois, 60064. Let the Lord touch your heart and be a blessing to the work of the Lord. May the Lord bless you is our prayer. We pray that the Lord has given you of his word to stir your heart. If you're saved, to stir up your pure mind, to encourage you to stay with God. And if you are not saved, to trouble your heart and bring you to the knowledge of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ came to save and seek those that are lost. So we thank God for all of you. May you be blessed. May you be healed. May you be strengthened in the Lord Jesus Christ. May you be encouraged. We also want to encourage you that go on our webpage, www.gsjministries.com. All of our information that is pertinent to you in terms of the announcements that we have, in terms of the call, the prayer lines that you can join in for prayer. All of our information is there that you will be able to access and know exactly what's going on. Also in that page, you're able to give. So if you desire to give, go on our webpage, www.gsjministries.com, and you can get whatever information that you need. You can receive it. So we want to encourage you to let's stay strong in the Lord. Also, we ask you, my friends, that when you call in to the various conference prayer lines, that you mute your phone. The reason why is because many times there's background noise. And when there's background noise, as the person is praying, it causes them to be interrupted. And we don't want that. We want it to, the prayer to flow. We want it to flow as God is leading an individual to pray. So please, when you go online, just keep your phone muted. And then as they come to the end of the prayer, they always ask everyone to unmute the phone so that you can praise God together. So if you would govern yourselves according to that, I know that you will be blessed and everyone will be receptive to what the Lord is doing. Again, may the Lord bless you. May you be healed. May you be strengthened. And may you be set free in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you.